dear friends. Wishing you all a very pleasant morning. I am here to share with you a few points of my knowledge about biodiversity, its importance, and some simple ways to conserve it for our future. Well, biodiversity. What do you mean by this? Let me explain. Have you ever noticed the variety of plants and animals around you? There are so many of them that we do not know even the names of many animals around us. All these species of plants and animals are collectively called biodiversity. Do you think it is so important to conserve? Yes, of course. Let me share the reason. It plays a major role in maintaining the balance of the earth. We have a popular proverb in Tamil, Seruga Katti Peruga Vaal. It is generally meant that we need to build a small house and live to grow it. Actually, it states that we need to, despite any small space we have, we need to live in biodiversity. To be precise, it states that we need to have at least some space in and around our house for plants and animals too. But it is not so in many houses. We live in cities and for many of us, plants and animals are something we look in books and watch in television. We are not mindful about its importance. We need to know the reality that the air we breathe, the water we drink, the food we eat, all ultimately rely on this biodiversity. If they do not exist, the ecological balance will be troubled. Some of the obvious examples are of plants and bees. Without plants, there will be no fruit, there will be no oxygen to breathe, and without bees to pollinate, there will be no fruits or nuts. Despite being so important for our survival, we are destroying our biodiversity. Lands are cleared for constructing houses and industries. Poaching of animals and unsustainable hunting are the other major threats to the fauna. How can we fix this issue? Simple, we need to give nature its space and protection it needs. Wildlife reserves are one of the solutions to these problems. I have some simple suggestions that we as children can educate our surroundings and conserve biodiversity. Number 1. Reuse products like plastic and glass in household till they are worn out. This process protects trees and forests using in paper products. Number 2. Pick up litter like aerosol cans and plastic papers from yards, parks and gardens. They do not get decomposed soon. Number 3. Plant at least some flower plants in yards and gardens outside the house for the bees to help in pollination. If there is no sufficient place, plant them in containers and place them on compound walls and terrace. Number 4. Reduce your shower time and preserve water. Number 5. Place some water and grains for the birds to consume. Number 6. Walk short distances instead of using vehicles. Number 7. Have a small organic dump yard at home for disposing kitchen waste, which is food for microorganisms in the mud. Number 8. Avoid using products like leather, timber, etc. that can affect biodiversity badly. Number 9. Ask your mom to get silk saris which are cruelty free. We all can make a difference when it comes to protecting our environment. To conclude, I would like to say that we should take all the essential steps to make our environment better. Thank you for your time and patience.